Today, we'll be looking at whether or not AI has human rights. If you're new to this channel, welcome. This is Mr. Singularity, where we explore the scientific and technological breakthroughs shaping the future as we know it. Human rights are intended to grant citizens equality, the right to work and education, and freedom from slavery and torture. Unfortunately, these rights, as they are not necessarily universal or upheld. But may we quickly see a full shift in their simple concept for a potential world? Human beings are not the only creatures to have freedom. Our ability for empathy also helps one to interact with other living beings and, as such, to apply animal rights to other species, with the goal of ensuring that animals have their own existence, that they can live their life peacefully and without suffering. There are still obvious levels at play. However, with certain living other beings, such as certain insects, not granted rights to the same degree. For example, there are no laws against killing ants or other rodents, but there are laws against hunting those other species. And while animal rights are not widely agreed upon around the world, every state in the U.S. has at least certain animal cruelty laws that forbid the excessive killing or injury to animals. So where, if ever, will robots be allowed to reach the field? If technology continues to develop, conscious robots are projected to become a possibility in the near future. But can or should they be given the same rights? Or are they only to be regarded as objects to be owned as property? We consider a being to be alive if it carries out such actions, typically if it is capable of developing, reproducing, and/or reacting to its environment. On this basis, however, some AI may even be found alive. Although they do not develop physically, they absorb new knowledge and integrate it into their programming, thereby their brains. Some may respond to external stimuli by doing things like moving on their own and engaging in games without assistance. And while AI doesn't and can't replicate physically, robotics professor Jonathan Roster, speaking to Open Mind in 2017, is only one of those who says that one day they'll be able to do it. One day, we'll have robot replication. Similarly, if AI has ever been mature enough to learn how to build other artificial beings by programming themselves, another predicted advancement in the future, then in a way that also might be used as a means of reproduction. Obviously, the distinctions between living and non-living creatures are more than blurred as we throw sentient AI into the mix, however. Generally speaking, the notion that AI does not deserve privileges is the most common side of the debate, based loosely on the assumption that AIs do not have their own separate, living human body. They are not made up of living matter, just metallic objects, and thus, as the theory goes, they do not merit the same moral concern. However, it may be argued that this is an erroneous view. For one thing, Professor Hugh McLachlan, writing for the discussion in 2019, points out that we still give rights to those that are not alive, that is to say, to people who have died with stuff like trusts, organ donations, and land that have been done to their liking. Future generations of human beings, too, do not have a physical body, but we also make choices in the present with their future rights in mind. In all cases, we grant rights to those who are not alive at present, yet we're not going to recognize the privileges of a robot that is alive in the present? And also, there are some cases of definitely non-human beings that have earned human rights, status, or beliefs in the past. In New Zealand, for example, the 2014 Te Urea Act essentially granted the forest the same legal rights as an individual. And then, more generally, even companies should be viewed on par with humans, with U.S. businesses working with some of the same civil rights, including freedom of expression and the right of lawful assembly, as if they were individuals themselves. In reality, it's through such loopholes that some AI rights campaigns are being developed. For example, in 2016, the legal analyst, Sean Bayer, showed that any machine could potentially apply for privileges equal to the individual if it took over the corporation, which means that it could legitimately own land and even sue anyone it wanted to. With how fast we seem to be heading into an autonomous workplace, as far-fetched as these arrangements sound, they may not be science fiction for much longer. Just allowing the right to live, organic bodies could potentially become a huge nuisance to us in the future. With robotic arms, enhancements, and body alterations being more and more sophisticated, others claim that it is now simpler than ever to foresee a day where most people have cyber-enhanced portions of their body. And, much farther down the road, a time where humans could be made entirely of inanimate materials. Today, we are also far from the issues that might occur if, when, humans legitimately become cyborgs. But it is one strand of AI where civil rights are and will certainly be heading. To go a step further, mind uploading is the concept of moving the whole human consciousness to a robotic body or machine, where it might potentially exist indefinitely. This unique strand of futuristic science fiction technology also has a lot of backers too, with some even claiming that it might be a possibility in only a few decades' time. Considering that we have already seen projects such as Blue Brain Project study digitally recreating part of the brain of a rat, that is, an organic brain developed inside a machine instead, there have been several big strides in this direction. So let's presume we're moving down that road. Then what about AI rights? The possible existence of a human brain in an AI body will naturally carry with it a whole new discussion about what constitutes a living thing. But then it would also cast doubt about what actually constitutes an AI. Scale down to more traditional robots, though. Certainly man-made machines with mechanized brains, and we get down to the forms of AI that we're used to seeing in the world today. On the end of the spectrum, we've got stuff like automatic checkouts in the grocery store, and on the other, we've got cases like Sophia, perhaps the most popular AI on the planet. For others, even computers as impressive as Sophia will never really be called sentient. The American philosopher John Searle's Chinese Room thought experiment tends to outline that robots and humans will never be the same. The experiment goes that an English speaker is installed in a room and made to translate Chinese writing sheets into English on the basis of set rules and instructions. The paper that comes out is fluent in Chinese, but it's not the true translator. They've all followed the guidelines without even knowing the language. For Searle, the same can be said of AI. And it can never be fully sentient since it is only ever following a sequence of commands to behave as if it were. In this way, it may be argued that all AI, no matter how advanced, has been or would have been programmed by humans at some point in time. That humans as creators have rights, and that the computer as creation does not. More recently, however, there is a rising consensus against Searle's way of thought. Sophia has always proved to be a trailblazer, but also a dispute. The robot granted citizenship for the first time in Saudi Arabia, but the backlash quickly followed as Sophia ended up with more rights than some women in the region. Similarly, with more people now on board with the notion that AI should have corporate-style rights, it is again likely that computers could have more rights in certain countries than other people do. We're not there yet, so the pendulum will continue to swing enough that in some situations, a human is essentially regarded as less of a person than some robots are. And from there, anyone's guess is the future. Intelligent enough AI could not only outperform human beings, but also exist forever, so that the granting of human rights to AI could eventually intensify what science fiction generally called the robot's rise. But who's going to presume that a dystopic, automated apocalypse could really or need to happen? For many, the real controversy rests in our thoughts of consciousness and whether or not it should exist in a system. A 2017 article published in the journal Scientific entitled "What is Consciousness and Do Robots Have It?" Supposedly, since consciousness is still so undefined even in humans, it would be difficult to reproduce it in computers until we understand it better in ourselves. At that time, when humans are in any way capable of defining, quantifying, and actually recreating consciousness, maybe AI rights aren't something we should be concerned with. And in a future period where we will better grasp the essence of consciousness, it could be a much more clear matter. Right now, though, the controversy is continuing. As long as the Sophias of this planet are continuously strengthened and made to look more lifelike, as long as the prospect of fully self-improving, self-replicating, and self-sustaining AI lies ahead of us, the AI rights movement will continue to be on par with human rights. For others, it is a terrifying prospect that may go so far as to kill human dignity. For others, it is an inevitable development on a fast-moving, technical universe. For now, AI doesn't have civil rights. But however you look at it, it's an unresolved metaphysical debate with major practical consequences. What's your take on this? Let me know down in the comments below and check out one of these other videos. This has been Mr. Singularity, and I'll see you on the next one.